Hello everyone, my name is Sloan and welcome to my YouTube channel. We are out shopping today for Christmas, so when you're seeing this, it's after Christmas because I can't post this until after people get their gifts, but my mom put on her Christmas list this year that she wants a fun plant, and that kind of surprised me because I have gotten my mom a plant like for the last like three or so holidays, and this time I was like, I don't know if she wants to keep getting plants, maybe I won't get her one for Christmas, but then it was on her list, so I immediately thought that, well, if it's on the list, I better go buy her a plant. So I'm at Renovation Jungle, which is one of my top favorite plant shops in my area. And our main goal today is to get something for my mom. Maybe I will find a plant for myself or for a gift for someone else, but the main goal of today is plant for my mom for Christmas. And we also have to get a pot. So I'm gonna look at the pots here. If they don't have pots here, then we need to find a pot somewhere else, and there's a week until Christmas, so I don't have a lot of time to order something, so it'll be fine, it'll be good. I'm so excited to plant shop. It's been forever since I've been here, and yeah, that's all. I will meet you guys inside. Alrighty, they have these really beautiful lipstick plants like right out of the gate. I've never seen them this big before. I think this is a black pagoda. Yeah, for 46. And then this is just a normal one. Mona Lisa for 33. I'm really loving my lipstick plants right now. There's also a yucca cane for 73. I really want one of the geometric looking ones. Once the stores get those in again, because I haven't had them in for a while, I will probably get one. Over here, there's some peperomia. This one's a ripple peperomia. This one's also a ripple peperomia. I guess just a different kind. And there's a watermelon. I really want a watermelon peperomia. It's really just gotta think about like what would be fun for my mom. She has a lot of plants now. There's a peperomia obtusifolia. There's a Monstera deliciosa over here. I feel like my mom would like a Monstera deliciosa. She keeps joking about how plants with holes look like something's eaten them. This one's 50. It's got a really, really pretty new leaf right there. I don't know how much space I want to like, you know, get her a plant that takes up a ton of space. Like, there's a really neat alocasia. I don't know what it is or how much it is, and I don't want to knock it around, so I'm gonna leave her be probably. Here's a Caladium lindeni. I have one of these. It got spider mites, but it doesn't have them, you know. Or Xanthosoma, excuse me, lindeni. It's 35. I think my mom would really love a plant on a plank, but she has a really big golden pothos, so not this one. There's a summer glory something, philodendron summer glory. I have a little baby one of these, and I really love it. How much are you? Okay, it's 80. I'm gonna try to put it back in this way. I think these are so pretty. And they have some alocasia. I would never in a million years get someone an alocasia. They're too much work, but this one's flowering. Silver dragon for 60. It's very pretty. I love the texture of them. Ooh. Is this a cupria? I don't think I've ever seen one of those in my life. It's 50. Alocasia aslanii. It is quite pretty and large. Kind of matches my nails, like the veining. A Raven ZZ. There's actually a ton of alocasia down here. So this is probably the, oh, it's a Maharan. These feel like dragons to me, which I just love. It's probably like a ninja. What's a velvet for 26? Maybe my mom would like a philodendron birkin. Oh, it's in a white pot. It's 30, it's huge. I've definitely thought that she might like a big kind of pot. those. This is the green something, Global Green. And this one's got like all of the little spot, like more variegation over here. Over here is a Ficus Triangularis, a variegated one. I love these so much, but I killed mine. I love them. This is flowering. It's quite pretty. What is this? Cyclamen for $10. And there's a Philodendron Pink Princesses. Ooh, I really like that leaf. 76. Really quite like the pink on that leaf. There's a Philodendron Florida Ghost for 56. And some Painted Ladies. I love Painted Ladies. Maybe my mom would like a Painted Lady for 56. String of Turtles. Everybody loves. She would like a String of Turtles. That's 33. And my mom's really good with Peperomia, which is awesome. They kind of have more like hanging plants. It's always hard to film with backlit whenever I'm here. This is a String of Arrows for 32. And I want to figure out how I can show you these leaves. They're really neat. They're arrow shaped. I don't see any smaller String of Hearts. There's a massive String of Hearts here. But String of Hearts are a fun plant for sure. Another String of Turtles. This is a giant Crimson Queen for 63. Kalanchoe. More like cacti plants. There's like a tiny little String of Pearls. Those are fun. Okay, they have variegated String of Hearts, like a little baby one. For 18, it's warm from being in the sun. And a normal String of Hearts for 10. When it comes to String Ofs, I really like to get people more established plants because I think they're kind of hard to deal with. But this one's flowering, so that's really cool. But yeah, I think that the smaller strings are just like very difficult plants. What is this? Do you see how pretty that is? Oh my gosh, I want this for me. What is it? It just says cactus. Look at those flowers. I want to touch it. It doesn't even really feel spiny. It is so cool. Okay, there's a ton of Hoya hanging over here, and this is a little bit easier to film. I think this is actually a lipstick. Yeah, this is like a super normal lipstick plant for 44. I have one of these. I love it. The Hoya Lisa. This, dare I say, is probably my favorite Hoya. It's 110. It's absolutely massive coming out of the pot. Here's just a normal Hoya Australis. And then, I don't know, what is this? Anthurium? I feel like it is. Yeah, Radicans and Luxuriants for 40. It's really cool. It's a cool plant. My mom, I could also see getting her like something giant like this, like just like something hanging. I don't know. Gosh, I don't know what the price on that is. Up too high for me. Over here, so there's a ponytail palm. Mom has a giant one, but she loves her ponytail palm. I wonder if she would like a Hoya compacta. Like that's like a weird fun plant. This could be an acquired taste though. Not sure if she would like that or not. There's little Hoya Lisas for 18. I can't remember what these are called. Tradescantias. Yeah, for $6. These Hoyas are a bit bigger, which is nice. Crimson Queen for 25. She might like these. She's got a decent amount of light in her house, so those will probably do fine. She's so good with plants too. Red Ardisia, that's quite pretty. It feels like an outdoor plant. Ooh, I think this is a Crimson Princess. It is for 25. I prefer the Princess. Ahoya would be really fun as a gift. We have the ZZ Zen Z. And a big whale fin. Let's check out kind of the other side of the store. Over here is kind of their front area. There's this Monstera. I think the baskets are really cute too. Is this a, I don't remember the name of this Monstera, but it's definitely a Monstera. And then they have like all of these little plants. I love that this cactus has little pom-poms on it. I'm tempted to do that to my cacti. I have a variegated African violet. My grandma would love this because she has African violets, but she doesn't have a variegated one. Am I just gonna buy plants for everyone that I know? So it's a 15. Ooh, she would love that. Okay, this is the Alocasia cuprea. It's so cool. I feel like even their old leaves kind of look like new leaves. Maybe that's some of the what people like about them. Those are pretty cool. More plants down here. This coconut palm is neat. I bet my mom would love to have a coconut palm. It's huge though. How would I even wrap that? I bet she would love that though. Ooh. That's tempting. Just thinking about it. This is the cuprea also. Here's, maybe get a better view. A little bit. There's tiny little macrame ornaments. I made one of these stars last year with beads and it was so, so difficult. Actually, like it takes a lot of work to make these. That one's $7. The frosted heart syngonium for $36. Oop. I love mine. I could always get her a cutting of mine if I wanted to give her one. And then there's some plants over here. I think they're being watered, so I'm not gonna bother them. And then they have like all of these pet safe plants. So a lot of these are marantas, or like prayer plants. So my lemon lime maranta looks so bad, and I have been debating getting a new one. It's just to make it look better. I wonder how much this one is if I wanted to refresh mine, but it's only 25, but I have so many projects, like plants to repot as it is. I don't know if I need like another plant in my house right now. I don't know. These jungle velvets are so pretty. My mom really loves the way that prayer plants move. You know how they like open and close at night? So I actually, when I went in here, I was kind of planning on getting her a prayer plant, but maybe we'll get her something else. I was thinking about getting her a rattlesnake calathea because this, I feel like the way that these move is my favorite. They like open and close. This one's huge though. It's 56. I was hoping they would have something a little smaller because it's gonna be hard to find a pot this big. Like it has less to do with the size. It's just like getting a pot that big that's gonna be cute is gonna be kind of difficult. I don't know. Oh, I also was thinking about getting another red maranta to refresh my red maranta as well. My red maranta looks slightly better than my green maranta, slightly. This is really cool too. I think this is technically a Tenanthe Burl Marx for 38. I'm so bad with the names of prayer plants. This is beautiful and huge. Oh my gosh, do I want this for me? Look at how pretty that is. For 35, Calathea medallion. That is so pretty. I'm gonna have to do like another lap around the store when I'm done filming, just to think about it. This is a Roy Astralis, but it's got like the little Lisa leaf down here. Look how cute that is. For 43. It has two stickers on it. I wonder if they bought it as a Lisa and then it reverted. Like a weird leaf right there. This little area that I'm standing in is so warm. It's really cold here now. They have some ferns. Ferns are kind of a hard thing to buy someone else because they're ferns. Oh my gosh, look at how creepy that thing looks. This is a kangaroo paw fern, probably called that because of these weird creepy looking things.
What the heck?
Oh my gosh. Oh, my mom has bird's nest ferns and she really likes those. I think that's what this is. If not, this is a Victorian bird's nest fern, so maybe it's a little different, but she really likes those. So I'm just trying to give you a sense of like her taste. This is random, but they also have these baskets. Can I get her a basket to put her plant in? It's $50 for the little one, $70 for the big one. They feel very well constructed. And then over here is a bird's nest fern. So this is what she has for $20. She got hers from IKEA. And then this is the Victorian version. So if you know anything about posting to YouTube, you know that if you monetize your content, sometimes if there's music in the background, you can run into issues where you can't post because of the copyrighted music in the background. So this little section of the video, there was a song playing in the background that I can't have in the background if I want my video to be monetized. So I decided to voice it over because I've been having so much fun voicing over videos lately. But anyway, there was a Hoya cortesii and a silver lace fern. And then this section of all of these smaller plants, there's a Hoya publicalis, which I've already given my mom a cutting of mine back over the summer, maybe for Mother's Day or for her birthday or no reason. I don't really remember. So she doesn't need another Hoya publicalis. And there's Hoya bellas here, which I'm not sure if I've ever seen one in real life. I really like the variegated ones, though. I would love a variegated one for myself, not for my mom for Christmas. And there's a bunch of smaller plants. I probably wouldn't get someone a small plant like this as a gift, so I'm really just looking for me. They have a Dischidia, and then this said it was an Enjoy Pothos, but this leaf that I'm about to touch really says pearls and jade to me, but I get kind of confused with the different types of pothos that are out there. I think it's just pothos as the plural. I should have looked that up. I messed that up in my last video. I said pothos is on accident. Anyway, there's silver striped philodendrons. I remember those used to be so hard to find, and now I feel like they're fairly easy to find for the most part. And then these Anthurium were so cool. It's an Anthurium, Radicans, and Luxuriants hybrid. Those roots stop me in my tracks. They're so awesome. But really the flower kind of attracted me over here to look at it. It's, and that new leaf, it looks very Hawaiian to me. I don't know if that makes sense to anyone but myself, but reminds me of Hawaii. And then this is technically the same plant, but look at how different the flower looks. And I think it was so cool. I love the flowers. Most people don't like the flowers in Anthurium, or at least I've heard that. And I don't know. I think that they're pretty cool. And then over here is a Scindapsus terbuei Moonlight. This would look so good at the top of a bookshelf hanging down. I actually kind of want to go back and buy one for myself, and I've never really been that interested in that kind of plant, or in that particular plant, but that one looked a lot like watercolor to me. And then that's kind of the rest of the wall. We already looked over there. Over on this table there is a Calathea white fusion. This is probably the prettiest white fusion I think I've ever seen. I bought one a couple of months ago. It is now DED dead. It had spider mains pretty bad, but it wasn't that pretty. That one was gorgeous. There's a Calathea exotica, and down here on the bottom, there's a Pilea peperomioides. I have one. My mom has one. My mom actually gave me a little baby one of hers, so that's the whole reason I even have one, is because she gave it to me. So definitely don't need to get that, but those little babies on the stem are so, so cute. I love how they propagate. There's some philodendron birkins and a philodendron silver sword. I think that would be too high maintenance for my mom, like having to do the moss pole and stuff. Lemon button fern. She would probably like that because my mom does like her ferns. And that's a pretty cute fern, but I don't know how easy it is to grow. There's a Burl Marx philodendron over here that is so full. It's actually, usually I feel like I don't see them that size in my area. That was a good size Burl Marx. It wasn't too big, but it wasn't too small. This is a Stromanthe sanguinea, I believe. I don't know if I'm saying that properly, but I like the dark leaves. They are pretty neat. And then last but not least, this green Maranta. And after that, I kind of looked around the store and I will meet you guys back outside. So that was very successful. And I will have to show you the plants when I get home because this is currently what they look like. So see you in a second. Back home, I'm pumped because I thought that was gonna be like this big ordeal and I was going to have to go, like maybe I find a plant there, but then I'd have to like go drive somewhere else and find a pot or like quickly try and order a pot online and like hope it shows up. So that went much smoother than I anticipated. I got everything I needed for my mom right in Renovation Jungle. And after I did my second round around the store, after I stopped filming, I did find that they did have smaller Calathea rattlesnakes. So that's what I ended up giving her. So, and they had this cute little pot in this little house. And it looks so cute with this little tray. So this is the whole little setup. I think she's gonna love it. And they even potted it up for me, which is so awesome. That saves me the effort of having to do that. And they added a little tag on how to like take care of it and everything. So it's perfect. What a good gift. And I ended up, so I looked at the coconut palms for a while and I talked to the person that was working there. They're so knowledgeable there. And I was like, do you know anything about coconut palms? Because I look at that coconut palm and I think that's a plant that's probably not going to do that well inside, you know? And we were just talking about it and she said she didn't really know that much about them either. She looked it up and yeah, they don't do that great inside. It's probably not going to live that long. And I was thinking like, I don't know that I need to do that to someone else, you know, buy someone a plant that might not live very long. So Calathea rattlesnake it is, and this is just such a cute pot. So I'm pretty excited to give this to her. And I got this tall, funky one because why not? It's tall and funky and cute. So that's not everything I got. I did get a few other things. So I got this variegated African violet for my grandma. One of my favorite things. So I went in thinking like maybe I'll find something for someone, but not, you never really know if you're gonna see a plant that someone is going to love for a gift. But my grandma loves African violets. I know she doesn't have a variegated one, and I didn't have to get her a pot because I know she has a million African violet pots. So there's no point in getting her another one. She has a ton, but I really hope she likes this. We'll see. I'm sure she will, actually. I'm sure she will. But yeah, I thought it was really cute. I kind of want one of these for me, but they only had the one. So my grandma it is. And this one was for me. It's this little cactus with the flowers. I made this really cute cactus Hoya corner in my office recently. I posted it on my Instagram story. So if you're not following me on Instagram, I would definitely go follow me there. I've been way better about posting lately. I've been trying to post more about like my life and like more just pictures of my plants, how they're doing, that kind of thing. So go follow me on there. It's linked in the description, but it's just Sloan's Common Ground. If you look that up, you should be able to find it. But anyway, because I made that little corner, it's just made me a lot more excited about cacti and succulents. But I do find that cacti and succulents are kind of hard because they need so much sun and I only have so many south windows that are good for them, and so I have to be really choosy with which ones I bring into my house. But I couldn't resist this one. It's so soft. I did kind of peel it back to try and look at the cactus underneath, and it's a light green, but that's about all I can tell about it. But I'm pretty excited about that one to add it to my collection. But that is actually it. Like, I legitimately thought I was going to be running around all day to different shops. I was going to take you guys with me, but Renovation Jungle made it really easy. Just get everything all in one, potting it up and everything. Now I just have to wrap the plants, which I won't do until Christmas. So yeah, thanks so much for coming on that little plant shopping excursion with me. I post plant shopping videos all the time and also taking care of my plants and my favorite plants, just like all the plant content. So I would love it if you would subscribe to me here on YouTube, and I can't wait to see you in the next one. Bye.